The Soviet Union was looking for a new heavy tank to be in its ranks. They began with a prototype called the T-100, but that was way too heavy and went way too slow for their wants. And so the KV-1 was born. The KV-1 would have a single turret with a 76.2mm gun, with a few different variations as time went on. It would weigh in at about 50 short tons and had a 12-cylinder 600 horsepower diesel engine. It had a max speed of about 22 miles an hour and could go about 210 miles before refueling. The main purpose of this tank was to blast through heavily fortified buildings or structures to make way for the much quicker T-34s. It did its job exceptionally and was the most powerful tank at the time. It had up to 90 millimeters of armor, making it difficult for the German 88s to go through this tank head-on. There were many variations of the KV-1, which included the KV-1A, KV-1B, KV-1C, and the KV-85. The ultimate demise of this tank was the introduction of the new Panther and Tiger tanks from the Germans. The gun on the KV-1 was just not effective anymore, and the T-34 was much better supported with IS-1s or IS-2s behind it. It was, however, critical to the development of many other famous tanks, like the IS series, and the SU-152.